Hey there, guys, this is Reckles with Want to Buy Gold, and I have good news. I finally leveled up, or I boosted, Lloyd the 12th, the Void Elf. And he's a rogue, so I can finally start doing some pickpocketing guides. But this one's a little special. We're going to be talking about macros, and hopefully you can use this even if you don't have a rogue, because we're going to be talking about like general beginner to advanced macro concepts. So you can take some of these, and even if you're just a raider or PvPer, you can incorporate these into your gameplay. But let's get talking about pickpocketing. So you don't need a macro to pickpocket. The tab targeting system was improved in Legion. It's really, really good now. It prefers people in front of you, and it prefers nearby enemies. It doesn't go backwards to someone you previously targeted either. But you run into problems when those rules kind of conflict. So let's say you have an enemy that's far away but in front of you, and you have an enemy nearby but behind you. Then it kind of doesn't know what to go through, and you want more consistency and control when you're pickpocketing and you're farming and you're trying to do things quickly. So let's talk about getting more control in a macro. If you are doing a big group of things, sometimes in order to get close enough to pickpocket all of them, some of them are going to be kind of off to the side of you or behind you, and it's going to mess with the rule set. So we just do a slash cast at Mouseover Pickpocket. This just gives you more control wherever your mouse is over. You just click that macro and it pickpockets that exact thing. Now, for me, I'm a very visual learner, thinker, visual spatial kind of guy. So I like to kind of see the pattern that I'm making when I'm pickpocketing a big group. So I throw in a raid marker in at the end of this. So anytime I pickpocket someone, whoever I targeted gets a happy little star over their head. And then I can see that I kind of spiral inward. Now, for some people, they don't like Mouseover. They think it takes too much effort and they prefer kind of an AFK farm. So what we're going to do for them, we're going to make a scroll wheel macro. What we're doing here is just adding in slash cast pickpocket with the representation of tab. So target the next enemy. And this is slash target enemy. So when you put those two together and you bind it to a scroll wheel, you can just flip through a pack of guys really quickly. The problem with this is that if you have a quick scroll wheel, you can flip through too quickly, and you kind of got to go through them a whole bunch of times in order to make sure you get everyone. And it's just, it for me, I don't like knowing that I haven't pickpocketed everyone in a group. If you're just doing onesie-twosie stuff and you're just running around pickpocketing the occasional mob that's by himself, though, a really good way to do this AFK is to just add a clear target at the start of this macro. It doesn't cycle through things. It just targets the nearest thing. It's pretty much walking up to someone and pressing tab. And when you do that, it does a funny thing where it doesn't cycle through groups of enemies. It just picks the thing that's closest to you, in front of you, that you're facing, and pickpockets that. This is especially useful if you have an add-on like faster loot, which lets you, it removes that little laggy loot window thing. So that part of it is pretty much instant. Now, if you're searching around for pickpocketing macros, you'll probably find some that have distance, like max distances included for the targeting. As of 7 point something, that script doesn't work anymore, so it's not actually doing anything in the macro. It will still target someone more than 10 yards away. Take those out of your macros. It's not doing anything. So those are the three macros that I use, just the base tab targeting stuff, the AFK onesie twosie farms, and then whenever I'm in a group, I'll use my mouse over macros. Or if I occasionally just want to grab one guy that's a little too far away and I know that tab targeting is going to target to someone else, then I'll just click on him. But there are some other cool things that you can do. Let's say you're farming for the insane title and you want heavy junk boxes and you have a point to farm up 50 a day. That's your goal. Then you can include this into a macro to know how many you farm up. And I know this looks kind of intimidating, but it's really simple. All it's doing is saying, count how many heavy junk boxes are in your bags and set that equal to this variable A. And then it sets the variable A equal to this other variable B. And then before it sets the variable A equal to variable B, it asks, is variable A greater than variable B? And if you just looted one, then it is. So it prints out in your chat window like, hey, you have 31 heavy junk boxes. The reason why it's so complicated is you don't want it printing every single time you press the macro. You don't want it printing to your chat box. You have 30, you have 30, you have 30, you have 30, you have 30. Now you have 31. Grats. So you don't want that happening. There's a bunch of other cool stuff, but I think this is probably good enough to get y'all started. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching. And stay tuned because I'm going to have a bunch of pickpocketing guides coming out. And I want you guys to just follow along with me. Spend 30 minutes out whenever I put out a pickpocketing guide. And yeah, that's it. Go subscribe. Like the video. I'll talk to y'all later. Have a great day. Good luck and happy gold making, guys.